Moving a PST to Thunderbird. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got actually a couple of times over the past few weeks. Do I have to buy a PST to mBox converter to get my email moved over to Thunderbird? So this is a question that comes when folks are using Outlook Classic. In other words, the big, powerful Outlook email desktop client that is included with Microsoft Office / 365 / Copilot / whatever they're calling it today. And they're looking to switch to a different email program to run on their PCs. To be very, very clear, I'm not talking about the Outlook that comes with Windows. That is a completely different program. It shares only a name. And what we're talking about here is Outlook Classic. Typically, these folks are going to be moving to a tool like Thunderbird. Naturally, there are other tools you could move to, but Thunderbird is going to be my example, and the concepts, of course, always apply. So, getting your email from that PST into Thunderbird, well, that's actually going to take a little bit of effort. What I didn't know until researching this video is that the PST file format and the related OST file format, while proprietary to Microsoft, is actually well documented. That's enabled a wide variety of tools to be written that can perform the conversion for you. Now, you can purchase and use one of those tools. And of course, there are also free tools, though with varying reputation and quality. For what is typically a one-time conversion, I'm reluctant to actually spend money on it. Particularly when, with just a little bit of legwork and some time, you can do the conversion yourself. So let's take a look at where we are and walk through the steps of making the conversion. The starting point, of course, is Outlook Classic. So we're here in Windows 11. I want to point out that this is Outlook Classic. You can see the Outlook icon down there. That is the Outlook that comes with Windows. Again, that is not the Outlook we're talking about. We're talking about Outlook Classic. A quick way to confirm that this is what we're looking at is if I right-click on it, you can see that it is, in fact, called Outlook Classic. Now, I have in Outlook Classic two email accounts. These are both connected by IMAP. They're unrelated to what we're doing today. And I have this example PST. Now, a PST can show up either of two different ways. One, you can create one using the account settings options, or you can have one created for you if you happen to connect an account using POP3. PSTs are, I believe, still the default storage format for POP3 connected accounts. OSTs are the default storage format for accounts connected via IMAP. Another way to confirm this is we'll just go to File, Account Settings, and go to Account Settings again. And under Data Files, you can see the three data files that I'm using here today. I've got my example PST, which is what we're talking about today. And then I've got the other two accounts, each in their own OST. It's the contents of this example PST that we want to move to Thunderbird. And we're going to do it without using a third-party tool. You can see that in this example PST, I have, obviously there's a couple of folders that come with it, but I've created a new folder called Saved Newsletter, where I've thrown a bunch of askleo confident computing newsletters. Okay, the first step will be to upload the email we want to transfer to a transfer account. The way we do that is to create an account at, honestly, any of the free email providers that will support IMAP. I'm using Gmail in my example. In fact, if I go over to the browser here, I already have a Gmail account ready to go. It has no email in it whatsoever. I'm just showing you it here in the browser to show you that there is a Gmail account that we're going to use as kind of an intermediary. So what we do is go back to Outlook Classic, and what we're doing is adding a new account. The email address we're going to use is that of the Gmail account that I just created, which is askleotest2@gmail.com. It's handing over to Gmail to do the authorization. We want to continue. Yes, we want to give it all the permissions. Authentication completed. We can close the browser tab. And now, besides having gotten a security alert in the account because we connected another program to it, we can see here that we've successfully added askleo 2. We're done. And in fact, there it is, askleo test 2, my transfer account. And it has all of the Gmail folders in it by default. And you can see that, sure enough, it has the same security alert that we saw in the browser. I go back here, there's the security alert. And if we go back one more, we'll see that, yep, Outlook sent a test message to make sure that everything is working. I'm going to, in Outlook Classic anyway, go ahead and just delete those two messages because we don't need them. Now, the interesting part. I have an inbox at this Gmail account. I'm just going to use that since I'm not using this account for anything else. So I'm going to select them all with Control A and then drag, but not yet drop, onto the inbox. You'll notice that the little square underneath the pointer is just a square. If I hold down the Control key, it adds a little plus sign. The difference is actually important for safety. With the plus sign, we are making a copy. So if I release the mouse at this point, all of the email that is in saved newsletters has been copied to my askleo test 2 account. Without that plus sign, it's a move. Now, that may be what you want long term, but I much prefer to do that in two separate steps. We copy the email first, and if we want to delete it from the example PST, we can do that later after we're certain that everything has actually copied properly. So, we have done the first step. Because this account, my transfer account, is connected via IMAP, the email that we just copied into the inbox for that account has been uploaded. And we can confirm that by going back to the browser. And sure enough, there in the inbox are all of the, in this case, newsletters that I have in that PST. So far, we've taken the contents of my PST and uploaded it to our transfer account. You can probably guess what the next step is going to be. Step number 2, download and install Thunderbird if you haven't already. Needless to say, I have. This instance of Thunderbird does not have any email accounts configured in it yet. But you know what we're going to do. We are going to add an account. We'll set up another account. Email. I will go ahead and call this my transfer account since that's what it is. And it is the same email address, askleotest2@gmail.com. With an at sign. There we go. Configuration. IMAP is what we want. IMAP is what allows us to basically keep our folders and the online contents in sync. Hit continue. Once again, it's handed off authorization to Google for this. Yes, I do want that. I've entered my password. We'll hit next. Google is confirming that I want to allow Thunderbird all this access, which I do. And it's done. We have configured this account successfully. Click finish. And there it is. Askleo test 2 is here. And there's an inbox, which has, among other things, of course, some propaganda from Mozilla Thunderbird, which I totally understand and appreciate. But if we actually just go to one of the messages, there it is, right? These are the messages in my inbox. In fact, I can make this bigger so I can see all of the messages And we can see that all of these messages have been transferred to Thunderbird. Now, you'll notice we had a couple of pop-ups along the way because, of course, yes, Google's sending us security alerts. This is kind of funny because we will now have those security alerts in three different places. You can see them here in Thunderbird. You can see them here in the Google account where it says, yep, there's a security alert. And you can see them over in Outlook Classic because it's still connected to the same account. That's because these two programs are both connected to the same transfer account using IMAP. They are simply windows, if you will, onto the email that's stored online. Now, if I use any of these programs to delete those two security alerts, then they will be deleted in the other locations as well. That's fine. That's how IMAP works. That's kind of sort of what we want. But in case you missed it, we just did what we set out to do. The email we have here is now in Thunderbird. It's actually being stored in an MBOX file, what's called MBOX, the default, almost industry standard approach to storing email in plain text. So we've done it. That's all we had to do. We uploaded our email to a transfer account, and then we downloaded that email into Thunderbird. Simple as that. Now, you're probably not really done. We've got the email where you want it to be, but there are a couple of things you might want to consider. These steps are kind of sort of up to you. So back to Outlook Classic. Once you've copied your email out of Outlook Classic to the transfer account, you might consider disconnecting the PST if you're not going to use it anymore. So in this case, that's my example PST. It still has stuff in it, but I've just moved everything out. Presumably, that's because I don't want to use this anymore. So we will go back to File, Account Settings, and on that data file, example PST, we will simply say Remove. Now that PST, the file is still on the PC. And in fact, I recommend you back it up at this point. But it's no longer in Outlook Classic. We've moved everything out of it, so we probably don't want to. We've also moved everything up into the transfer account from Outlook Classic that we might care to. So there's really no reason to have that account connected anymore either. Same place. File, account settings here in email. There is Ask Leo Test 2, my transfer account, and I'll just click on remove. And yes, its offline cached content will be deleted. It'll be deleted from the PC, not from the account. Boom. So now my Outlook Classic is back to having only the two accounts I started with and not the PST. Now, once you've downloaded everything into Thunderbird, which we have, you might want to copy that email from the transfer account to local folders. Let me show you how that's done, and then I'll explain why. Under local folders, I'm going to create a new folder called newsletters, because that happens to be what we had. I'm selecting everything here, and I'm going to drag and, once again, make sure that it has a plus sign to copy everything to local folders. And local folders now has the 25 newsletters that we've been working with. We've copied everything originally from the PST up to the transfer account, from the transfer account down to Thunderbird, and now from Thunderbird, we're moving it from an account-specific folder to a local folder. Why does that matter? Well, two reasons. One, we're done with this account. We may not want it to be around anymore, so maybe we want to get rid of it. More importantly, if we take a look at what's in that account right now, that account's inbox, if I now go online and I select everything in that inbox and delete it, well, guess what? Once we go to Thunderbird, and once it synchronizes, well, all of the data in the inbox, it's gone because we deleted it. We wanted to save that. Local folders are not associated with an online account, which means the only things that happen to what's in a local folder is what you do on that PC in this specific instance of Thunderbird. Accounts, they're connected to their online counterpart. Especially when using IMAP, that means if you delete it in one place, it's deleted in the other. Since this is presumably something we wanted to keep, we don't necessarily want to do that. Okay, great. We're done with the transfer account. That means we can probably go ahead and get rid of that too. We'll go to Settings for the account, and we'll click on Delete. We can once again remove the message data, remove the account. Now, if we go back to the local folders after outside of account settings, we go back to local folders, our newsletters are still there. This specific instance of Thunderbird now has no email accounts configured. You can add more, do whatever you want later. But the bottom line here is that you have successfully moved the email that was in the original PST in Outlook Classic through a transfer account into Thunderbird, where it is now safely stored on your PC and will get backed up as you back up your PC. Now, there are a couple of what I refer to as elephants in the room when it comes to moving things around from a PST to Thunderbird, or actually, these are just very common account management issues, regardless of where you're moving from or to, or how you're doing the moving. One, contacts. There's really no seamless way to move contacts other than to export them from one program, say Outlook Classic, and then import them into the other, Thunderbird in our example. There will almost always be some form of data loss when you do that because not all contacts, programs, or applications keep track of the same information or even all of the information in the same way. That means when you transfer from one to the other, the stuff that the other doesn't understand kind of sort of gets lost. The other is your calendar. Honestly, I have yet to encounter any reliable approach to transferring calendar information, with the sole exception of specific services, like I experienced with Proton Mail, being able to copy from specific other services, like Gmail. For calendars stored in a PST, I really have yet to find a viable approach to moving them. So, there you have it. Not that bad. We didn't have to buy any additional tools. I hope that gets your email transferred. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/183844. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.